So Conan, or Conan, was the hero of a series of pulp stories written in the first part of the 20th century by Robert E. Howard. And that was famously adapted into one of the best sword and sandal genre movies of all time, Conan the Barbarian, which starred Arnold Schwarzenegger. It's being remade, of course, like everything that anyone else has ever even heard of before, and that remake comes out today. And I have to say, we saw it, and it's, you know, I would put up with almost anything just to see a movie like this on the screen. So if it has to be called Conan the Barbarian, it has to be a remake of a movie that doesn't need to be remade because the first one was almost perfect, I'll take it. Just so that I get to go see a guy swinging a sword around. I'll make that deal with the devil, I guess, to get to see it happen on screen. It's better than it probably should be. It's still missing something. The thing that it's missing, the thing that made that original Conan the Barbarian movie so good, was it was a perfect example of synchronicity in casting, where they just needed a guy that looked huge, and they found Arnold Schwarzenegger early in his career, and he was literally the biggest dude around. He won Mr. Universe contest because he was just huge. And he looked that way on screen, translated. And he couldn't speak English very well, so they didn't write him very many lines. And the lines they did write him made him look like an asshole, which is what Conan was in those stories. He was a drunk, rude, dumb asshole who liked to kill people. And that's what he was in the first film. And the reason that that kind of worked is that that kind of character, combined with a guy who's just massive, lent the character and lent the first film this kind of weird anarchic possibility that was embodied in the original Conan character. He was big enough and strong enough and weird enough and dumb enough and probably drunk enough that he could do stuff in the middle of the movie like punch a camel in the face and knock it unconscious for no reason. And that kind of spark of unpredictability is what made that character originally come alive. And it's kind of been trampled out because the guy that plays the new Conan speaks fine English. He's not as big, although he's got kind of big muscles, and he's more of just a kind of straight-ahead standard hero. And they pay homage to the original one because he treats a woman rudely for about 30 seconds. But other than that, he's basically every cinematic hero swinging a sword that's ever been. He's not drunk, he's not anarchic, he's not full of possibility. He's just a guy filling out the chain of events on his standard hero journey. Like I said, I'll take it just so I get to see a guy swinging a sword, because I don't get to see it enough these days, but it's not a patch on the original. For a movie that does embody that anarchic spark, a person that's just a caged panther on screen, who's huge and so perfectly embodies his character, that it's a movie filled with that anarchic sense of possibility, that weird sensation of anything could happen, good or bad, even though I'm following this guy's character through the story, watch Tom Hardy as Charles Bronson. Not Charles Bronson, the actor, Charles Bronson, the most notorious inmate in the English penal system's history, in Nicholas Winding Refn's Bronson. You'll recognize Tom Hardy from a bunch of million movies, the Batman sequel. He plays Bane in the new one coming up. He was in Inception. He's everywhere all of a sudden because he's incredibly talented. And in Bronson, he's the first guy really since Schwarzenegger to be, although he's not as big, but to have that kind of scary anarchic spark where you're just so big and so powerful and so able to demonstrate your power to the other characters in the space that you inhabit on screen, that it feels like that character can do anything and that anything can happen. And it won't just be a rote execution of go here, save the girl, fight the dragon, stab the guy, and then yeah. It's really good. So is the original Conan. It's so good. You can watch that instead if you want to. But watch Bronson, because it's got that same spirit.